Let me make sure that we are recording on every side tonight. This is a very important night. Amanda, are you there tonight?
Yeah.
Has Sean come home?
Yes, I have.
Okay, because he called me when he was still out there.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I just wanted to make sure that he's home. Okay. Sean, I hope you're well covered when you are out there. I hope you're covering yourself so that you don't catch cold and all of that kind of stuff. I can't afford to see you sick. Cleo, are you on tonight? Maria, please, let's try and make contact with Cleo. I would try and call her after the conference to find out what's really going on, because I've not been in contact with her, the Collins family, for a while in New York, and that's not funny, that's not fair. Yeah, I'll try and do something about it. Yeah. Doris, are you on with me tonight? Okay, she's not yet here. Because the topic we are dealing tonight is very, very important. It's a topic that nobody should afford to miss. Nobody should afford to miss. I don't know whether my godson is here tonight. I'm not sure. Please let me know the states that are featuring tonight. I know that the Yonkers are here from New York. I know that Washington is there. Please, can I hear from you and know exactly who are there, so that I know where I'll be channeling my bullets to tonight. I see today, most of the half of the day I spent it in the office, and half of it I went out to do a lot of errand that has piled up administratively. So that's why I wasn't able to call, but I'll call you tonight. I'll make sure I do. How was school today? It was. Are you feeling okay? Okay. You're okay.
I'm listening.
Okay. Are you working on a big one tomorrow, or are you taking the day off?
I'm taking the day off. I'm going with my friend Marley.
Okay. Just keep me in tune on what is happening so that I can journey with you a little bit, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Until we see the end of the whole thing, because it's not yet over. You know that.
Yeah.
You know that when I bet my life on it, you know that it's something far more serious than what you're thinking. I will tell you more things that you are supposed to know.
Okay, good.
There is something that I've been keeping from you. There's something I've been keeping from you from knowing in your last marriage, that I'm going to be sharing with you, because that's going to be very important for you to know that.
Yeah, good.
You're going to know that. And when once we deal with it, that will be over with. And that is connected with the topic that I've been teaching this afternoon. This afternoon, I taught on astrology and...
I listened to the very end of it. I caught the very end of it when you did the prayer. That's all I got to catch.
Okay. And also, I will want those of you who were not around during the morning communion service to go back and watch the video. There is a video out there in the internet that says Deliverance communion prayers. It is very, very powerful. I couldn't stop this morning. Normally, girl will tell me to stop so that she can go to school or go to her job or something. But I just went on and on and on. Maria didn't say anything. Nobody said anything. It just went on and on and on. It was at the end that I discovered that there were two videos happening at the same time. So the two videos for the morning prayers are in there. One of it is the morning prayer for day 29, and the other one is the prayer that comes from the communion itself. Please make good use of those prayers. Make good use of that video to pray for deliverance. And when we say deliverance, it means quite a lot of things to those of us who belong to this kind of thing. And then the afternoon session, I taught on astrology. You need to know a lot. The Bible says, for we are not ignorant of the devices of the enemy. If you are ignorant of the devices of your enemy, the kind of bullet they use, the kind of tactics you say, I don't care. I don't want to know what they do out there. Are you serious? Someone who is practicing those things can live downstairs and they will disturb everything you are doing upstairs. Someone who is practicing those things could be your fellow teachers and you have no idea. And you are out there eating all the potatoes and rice that you can eat, and that guy is seriously fasting and praying and getting more demons to do more harm. We should not be ignorant of their ways and their devices. Tonight, I am teaching on psychic powers, deliverance from psychic powers. Now, we have Florida in there. Let me hear of the other states that are in with me tonight, because I want to know where I'm going to channel my bullets to tonight, because I'm drunk with power tonight. I'm telling you. So somebody better keep me in check tonight. Yes, please tell me the states that are here. If you don't want to say anything, don't worry. I just want states. Don't mention your name if you don't want to. Who? Okay, Nebraska. Maria, are you on tonight?
Yes.
Oh, my sister. Wow. How are you?
I'm good.
Okay, how is Grace and the boy doing? They are doing okay?
Okay,
I know that the weekend is normally very busy for you. I know that it's also busy for my sister Devinda too. I know it's busy for her on Friday, Saturday, Sunday until Monday, then she begin to have some rest. Doris, the same thing too, and my godson in DC, the same thing. This is the videos of this afternoon. In fact, the videos starting from yesterday's video, the one on, or day before yesterday, the one on how to defeat witchcraft forever. You need to send it to your family members and friends. Go and look for that video. It's there. I've started again to send emails. I've sent some to you this evening. I will send out another one after the conference that will contain all the videos for the past 3 weeks, so that you have it and you can just click it at your email and watch it for those of you who do not know how to subscribe to me on YouTube, so that you can watch. There's a lot that you need to know so that you will stay free and remain free. Okay. Look for the one that says how to defeat witchcraft forever. And then there was another one yesterday that talks about, what was that? How people become witches. You do not know how people become witches, but you can go to New Orleans and buy witchcraft for a little or a dime, for a penny and a dime. You can go to Santa Fe, New Mexico. You can go to Albuquerque, the land of enchantment, you know, and get those things. You can go anywhere. It's an open thing. Witchcraft is big business nowadays. You can become a witch easily. I shared a lot about it yesterday, and today I started dealing with the other aspect of the occult world, astrology. Tonight, I'll be teaching on psychics. Okay, let's pray. Cover us, Lord, with the blood of Jesus. Every one of you, begin to pray to be covered with the blood of Jesus. Come on, begin to pray. Father, cover us with the blood of your Son. Cover me with the blood of your Son, O Jesus. Cover me with your blood. Lord, 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 cover your people with the blood of Jesus tonight. Shende kanda brando soko yende yasara mbratu seke ndiriandira kondo brinda sati yeke. Yundo mbrutike sende krando mbrunta sanda kachite renkrembondo rinde. Santo mbukuri ndara sanda brakunde sinde. Mikorondo prutita sinda kambaratunda sakuyanda buko yesende. Mo kondo mbruta si karinda bratu kondo brite sekende brantu kurondi sanda. Mo kondo mbruti si kenye yenda brakati yasinda. Mondo kondo bridati rasaka yanda. Mikandambra su kurombunde si ke yende rende urburo. Ye kondo brusinda rabratu tede. In Jesus' name, I destroy every traps, every manifestation of the works of darkness. I destroy them completely tonight.
Yes, amen.
Every hold back to your money, to your finances, to your marriage, to anything that you hold dear in your life, I destroy them by the word of my mouth, which are spirits and which are life. Tonight, I set your finances free. I set your marriage free. I set your children free. I set your job free. I set your health free. Everything about you is free.
Hallelujah.
And there is no power of the enemy that can touch you. Barbara of Wisconsin, are you with me tonight?
Yes, I am.
Very good. I need you to be in this program. My sister and lovely, lovely, lovely beloved sister. Shalene, are you on tonight? Geneva, are you on tonight? I don't know who is answering me. Yes, I don't know whether that's Shalene or Geneva.
Geneva.
Hi, Geneva. Good evening, madam.
Hi.
Hi. Now, let me begin to share some very vital and important things with you about psychic. Psychics are people who have spent some time to learn and advance and expand their aura, their vibration, and the ability to manipulate the soul realm. Yes, who just came in, please? Let me know.
Hey, in Wisconsin.
Kay Green, how are you, my lady?
I'm fine, how are you?
Good. Try and make sure that we get in touch, please. Okay, I've missed you for a long time. I need to hear your voice. Okay, let's continue. The topic tonight is very, very important. You see, psychics, some of you have ignorantly visited psychics. The reason is because you were desperate for help. You reached that place where pastors couldn't help you. You reach that place where your attorneys couldn't be of help to you. Parents were of no use to you. Children were of no use to you. You hated your job. You went to your pastor to help you. He could not. There was no bishop, no prophet, no apostles who could help you. So you turned to those 800 numbers. Or you just turned to one of them in your city and you went to look for help. But one of the things you did not know was who is the intelligence behind the psychic or in the psychic or operating within the psychic or through the psychic. A psychic is, you see, there are people, okay, let me put it this way. How do people become psychic? People inherit psychic powers. Psychic powers are or is the manipulation of the soul realm. Psychic science or art or practices is concentrated in the soul realm. And most often expands into the spirit realm. Because the spirit controls both the mind and the spirit itself and the physical material world, so psychic powers penetrate beyond the soul realm. While witchcraft attack from the spirit realm, listen to me carefully. While witchcraft works from the spirit realm directly, because it is connected with demons immediately, it's a worship of demons. The psychic science and art and occultic practices is its department is to attack and to work and expand within the soul realm. You see, they all have divisions. So while witches work from the spirit realm to attack you, or to do their work, or to do their practice, the psychics work from the soul realm. And all of them are geared towards the same thing. It is bondage. It is manipulation. You see, psychic works is to manipulate the soul realm. The soul realm has to do with, listen carefully, intelligence, memory, the conscious, unconscious, non-conscious existences in the mind world, in you. There are so many worlds in you, so many systems in you. And the psychic goes straight for your soul. While the witch tried to go straight for your spirit. So this is how this goes. Your soul also is made up of willpower, the ability to will things. That's why you hear me when I pray, I say things like this. When I'm doing a very serious prayer for you, you hear me say things like this. Nobody is allowed to disobey or to, how do I normally put it when I'm praying? When the Holy Ghost is leading me, it's a different thing. But let me put it the way I normally hear me say it. Nobody is allowed to walk against my will. To walk against my will. The work of the psychic is to hold your will in bondage. And remember that a psychic works with either or. Number one, a power of a witch, or he or she works with directly with fallen planetary demons. I'm playing with words. He works, what I wanted to say is, he works directly with fallen angels. Fallen angels. And what happened is, the breakthrough normally comes with the infiltration. His words, the word of a psychic is words that calls demons to take over your mind or to influence it or to hold it in captivity, in hostage, and not only that, and monitor it. So while you go to a psychic to read your palm and tell you what they are seeing, they are actually behind the curtain doing one thing, drawing you in to bondage without you knowing it. So that you will begin to depend on the psychic for your life and existence. That is the reason that sometime when you leave the psychic and you stop seeing the psychic, he or she, just like if you start going to a wizard, a warlock, a witch for help, or a diviner, or a medicine man, or a shaman, or an enchanter, etc., or an herbalist that uses the dark forces, if you stop, or the witch doctor, if you stop going to them for help, they will then pronounce a curse on you. And that curse is, bum, 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 a demon is sent, a violent demon is sent after you to trouble you. Or a squad of from hell is sent to do everything to disorganize you and make your life miserable until you return back to the psychic. Because the aim of the psychic is to control your soul and to determine what you do. That's what it's about. And your money is held in bondage. In fact, let me say this. If you've ever been to a witch or to a psychic, if you've ever been to any of these people, medicine man, lodges, occult, all kind of stuff, please, if you've been there, witch doctors, make sure that you try and connect with me. Because they might have cursed your money. They might have cursed your marriage. They might have cursed your organs. They might have cursed your fortune. They might have cursed your chances. They might have cursed everything about you, and you have no idea. And if I do not reverse those things by speaking the blessing over you, you remain cursed. Make sure you go back and look at the video on astrology that I just did today. Make sure you do. It's very, very important. When you go to a psychic, what do a psychic normally do? Let me see whether any of you have been there before. Please speak aloud. Don't speak gently. Anyone who has been to a psychic, please speak and let me know. Because you see, let me share this with you before you jump in. Let me share this with you. Some people are born with psychic ability, the ability to enter into your soul and connect immediately with what has transpired in the soul realm for many generations ago. They can do it in a second. How are people born with it? Because there was somebody in the family that was a psychic or a witch or belonged to the mermaids or was completely sold to the other camp, the camp of the dark forces. And so, if someone in the family belongs to that or participate in that in the past, now let me share something that you have to know. I have to tell you this. And I'm going to tell you with a very heavy heart. Because this is where most of our problems comes from. When someone in your family went to any of those places, whether a native doctor or a witch doctor, whether a psychic, a fortune teller, a vampire, a warlock, a witch, a diviner, a medicine man, an herbalist, a diviner, a voodoo priest. Okay, welcome, my brother. Remember, Freddy, that no weapon that is fashioned against you will prosper. Remember that I've said so.
I receive it.
Good. No matter what somebody is doing at the other side of Ohio, that arrow cannot come near your house. I've said it. So if they like, let them go to the highest mountains in the Dakotas. If they try anything, they will see me right there with them. I'm telling you what I'm telling you, so you better tell them to back off. The pastors, they are afraid of these things. That's why their members are going to what I'm talking about. If someone in generation past or present has gone to any of those places, a fortune teller, there is something that transpired between if the person's power came from the water world or from the world of the fallen stars or from demons, however it came from Leviathan, however it came from, whichever of the forces of darkness that they solicited for help. If you go and visit those people, you have unknowingly asked for a fallen angel or a demon, or a demon, especially a demon, because demons are the ones that they use for this job. Demons are particularly the easiest one that psychics use, witches use, and people in the dark forces, they use demons easily. While the fallen stars are coordinators and gatekeepers, demons are the police officers, the enforcers of these things. Unknowingly to you, when you consult these people, psychics, to see into your future, to read your past, to read the meaning of omens for you, to help find out why you are having the problem and solve it, this is what happens to you. Unknowingly, since you are ignorant of the devices of the enemy, you've fallen into a trap. But they will never tell you, not in this physical planet, that you've fallen into a trap. And a demon will be sent to save you, to walk with you. And that demon become a slave to your family. Hear me well. This is heavy tonight. The reason why many families suffer and can never make it in life is because there is a slave demon. A demon. I'm not talking of a human slave. There is a demon that is part of that family that has not been sent back. That demon was bought and paid for because you paid the psychic. You paid the astrologer. See, there is always money. You never show me one psychic or fortune teller or whoever of this group that you will go to to inquire of anything that money doesn't exchange hand. Is there any of them?
No.
Never will there be. Not even those who, when I check out a romance for you, you will always give money. And the reason is this. That money bought a demon for you. To save you. To work with you. When I say to save you, I mean S-E-R-V-E. He becomes a servant to you and to your children for many generations to come. And you don't have no idea. That is how people get married. I'm not talking of the water world now. That is how, in one specific way, not all the way, this is just one of the way, that a man become married to a demon. A demon become married to a man. A woman become married to a demon. A demon become married to a man. Because money changed hand. That's why when I tell some of you, please help me run this ministry, and you think, oh, he's just trying to take care of himself, buy things. No. Money must change hand for things to be kept normal for you in the supernatural realm. That's why those people in the occultic realm can never look up anything for you unless the fee is paid. And that money pays for a demon that follows you forever. Unless someone like me, I'm now telling you what is happening. And that is why whatever you try to do, there is a problem. Because a demon has not been sent back. That's where all this problem is coming from. A demon will refuse to go because he was bought and paid for by either you or somebody in your family unknowingly. So why, while you people and while you go about looking for pastors to pray for you, the pastors have no idea of what I'm telling you. That the real issue is, normally when I'm praying for people, that's why I don't tell people everything so as not to scare them. It's because I'm seeing who bought and paid for the demon that is at work in this family. Someone went. Okay, let me continue to talk. So listen to this. So many a times, people don't get this. And so, pastors and bishops and our prophets and apostles and teachers, they will pray. Nothing happens. Because they have no idea. That's why when I'm ministering to people, I always ask them, where have you been before? Have you ever visited so-and-so? Some people lie to me. And I said, don't lie to me. Tell me the truth. And they say, yes, I visited a witch doctor. And then I realized that they have bought and paid for a demon. And there is a demon that is a slave in the family. When a demon comes in, it doesn't want to go out. That's why you don't even go there. Because they do not want to go back to hell. So when money changes hand, that's why some people, I tell them, help my ministry so that I can spend days and fast with you. And they are like, oh, then they go. They don't come back. They go to another pastor who will do it for them for free. Are you serious? Go to the other side and see whether they will do one thing for you, except you pay heavily. You pay big money for it. And they will see for you. They will see for you. The only problem is this. You're buying and paying for a demon to come and become a member of your family or a member of your life or to participate in your life for a very long time, and you have no idea. And things begin to go wrong. Why? Because you failed to recognize the presence of what you bought and paid for. You failed to recognize the presence of what your parent bought and paid for. And they think get angry that you are not using him or her. How will you feel if you got married? Every morning the wife wake up and look at you. Good morning, sir. You don't even listen. Good morning, madam. You don't even listen. And the demons sit day in, day out. You don't use it. Let's use it. If a man goes and marry a wife, you don't do what husband and wife are supposed to do. They'll start thinking something is wrong with you, that you are suffering from impotenta. Is this guy impotent or what? What's wrong with him? The woman says, I married into this to have all the fun in the world, perhaps have children, do my duty. Why is he like this? So you go and buy and pay for a demon. The demon every day get up in the morning and sit there watching you. You don't send it to do anything until he get fed up with sitting and doing nothing. And he start to trouble the family. So what the hell is going on? I want to do something. And nothing. The same thing with those of us who are Christians. Jesus paid for us to have angels. And we don't even use our angels. We don't even know how to. I'm going to teach you on how to activate your angels. If you guys will support what I'm doing financially, then I'll have the time to sit down and teach these things so that I do not worry about anything. There's a lot that you need to know that nobody's teaching you. And nobody is ministering to you one-on-one. That's where the real issue is. So make sure you send a demon that you bought and paid for. Make sure you send it back. Make sure you send it back. If you don't know how to send him back, contact me. And please donate generously, because it's a very dangerous job too. Donate generously to my ministry. Go to my website and donate big time to my ministry. And some of you, your parent paid for a demon, your mother paid for another one, your grandfather paid for another one. So some families has like about 3, 4, 5 demons in the family. All of them are slaves, waiting for a job to do. And when there is no job for it to do, it creates a job for itself and start doing a job for you. Sometimes it get angry from you, get that job from you so that you can recognize his presence. It's happening all over the world. It's happening. Many a time you go to a psychic and a psychic hold your hand. And what do the psychic do?
Yeah.
Welcome. And a psychic hold your hand and begin to tell you what he or she has seen. Now, let me ask that question again. Who has ever been to a psychic, and what did they do? What do they use for their practice? What did you see? What did he or she tell you? I'm listening. Please talk aloud. I'm talking about, have you experienced that before? Have you been there before?
Yeah, I've been there before.
Okay, and what happened?
Basically, the guy was just looking at me and I'll say something.
Was it a guy? Was it a guy?
Yeah, it was a guy and a girl.
Mm-hmm. And what did they have? What did they have in their presence or where they were staying that you went to visit them? What did they have in the house? Mm-hmm.
Like, I guess, a bunch of, like, it's a botanical store. It's a lot of voodoo stuff, a lot of think it was Bible hours.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
And you know what a Bible hour is? Where is Doris tonight? Is Doris with us tonight? She's not here, and Deborah is not here. Those are Nigerians. Babalawos are Yorubas. They are the Western people of Nigeria. And Babalawos are the native witch doctors. They are not just practitioners of medicine. They are some native, they are some Babalawos that practices traditional medicine, alternative medicine, that has nothing to do with witchcraft. But it's rare to see those ones. It's rare. These ones are actually witch doctors. They are witch doctors from the Western tradition of Nigeria. Continue. Yeah, because you see, the Yoruba religion is not just in Yoruba. It cuts across a lot of countries. You find it in most of the Hispanic-speaking countries. They are there. And so what did they tell you? What did you pay them? What was the fee?
$20.
A dollar?
No, I gave her $20 for a reading.
Okay.
Besides that, I went in the store and bought a lot of oils and beads. I used to wear those beads.
Okay.
So I used to wear a lot of those Caesarea beads, so I know a little about that.
Okay. Okay, what did they tell you?
She told me that to stop. I wanted to know why I was so much drama in my life, why I kept arguing in prison a lot. And she said something about bad luck. I had bad luck and to stop cursing a lot because my guardian angel doesn't like it and stop listening to bad music. That was about it.
Okay.
I left the store because we bought this little statue from there, and I went in the store and I basically exposed him. I was like, "This is not of God. This is a demon." And he kind of caught an attitude. He said, "Who told you that?" And I don't know. I was on the computer one day and I heard this lady saying something about idol worship. And then that last time I checked, I was an idol. So I went back in the store and said, this is not of God. And I got hooked on to the game. I knew that a lot of that stuff wasn't of Jesus.
Okay. Thanks. That's good. Who again has ever visited a psychic? Please speak up. Do you know who is talking through her?
I'm sure now I'm
there is always a demon inside the psychic or the astrologer. There is always a demon, and that demon, immediately you enter inside that hotel room, if you come close to about 10 yards to where that woman is staying, she is in charge of that territory at that time. It's just like where I am in Wichita. I will not tell you. Let me just stop so that I don't say too much about this. But you see, when once you enter into that hotel room, you are in her territory. And the demon in her immediately, automatically, is in a second, zap into your soul and zap every problem that you've had for the past, how many years, sometimes generation past, it zaps in immediately. And through the Spirit of God, right. There you go. Did she give you anything? So she said that the relationship between you and your daughter will never be good in this lifetime.
Yeah, so she told me it would get better, but it would never be what I wanted it to be.
Did you know what that was?
What?
That is what we call a curse.
Okay, yeah. It bothered me. It always bothered me that was
bad. Okay, let's do it. Let's remove what she said. I destroy the curse that was put on you between you and your daughter. I destroy it completely. And now I restore a free Spirit of God flowing relationship between you and your daughter. And I destroy every curse that was put into you and your daughter. I destroy them. And I release the spirit of freedom and truth and favor. The spirit of union. The spirit of working together. The spirit of fun. The spirit of joy. The spirit of favor. The spirit of gentleness. Kindness to come between you and your daughter, both now and forever. Amen. Okay. Yes, who again has something to say?
This is Nuwet in Seattle.
Huh?
This is Nuwet calling in Seattle.
Hi. Blossom, how are you? What is your culture?
Vietnamese.
Oh, Vietnamese. Okay.
Yeah. So I have Chinese, Vietnamese, and French.
Okay.
Married twice and so it
Okay. Okay. You see, it's very difficult for demons to give you a 100% good things. The reason is because they always want to see you suffer, because suffering is what gives them advantage. Sadness, bitterness, unhappiness, sorrow, death, pain, sickness is what they use as a leverage, as an advantage over humans, until you know your place in Christ. So they will never tell you five good things without telling you two or three bad things that will also happen to you. And those things are things that they themselves create. They do not solve problems. They put problems. Who again has something to say? Please, somebody is moving around. I should have muted their phone. I don't understand why some people, when they come online, no matter how much I talk, they cannot obey anybody. This is not funny at all. I'm telling you, this is not funny. Who again has been to a psychic? Okay.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it Maria?
Yes.
Okay. Did they give tell us, let's hear.
The sorcerer is a Muslim. Two of them. Wow, three of them. Well, more than that, I think. Maybe four. I talked to three of them two of them in the phone. One of them, I've been going to
meet
in person.
Right here in America?
In America, in Alaska, this year.
Okay.
Oh, he gave me something that coming from his country, some kind of milk. I drink that, is very bitter for a couple of days. I drink that. And then he gave me some kind of bath. Money, different kind of money. And then when I come back from work, I'm becoming very weak. You know, I have to go straight up to his house. And he has to make some kind of a smoke, and then I'll be okay. So I get it to some kind of point that I do not like it, and I look for God. And that's when I start looking for prayer lines on YouTube. That's how I get back to God.
How much did you pay him?
A lot of money.
There you go.
Different of them, and one in Africa. I sent him even thousands.
How much have you given to me since you started talking to me?
Nothing.
There you go. This woman has never given me a dime, and she has paid all the thousand to those people that never help her. Interesting, eh? And that's what happened to a lot of people. They go to other people and spend so much money. And then they come to me and they get the deliverance and they get everything, and I receive not even a dime. I know about your own case. Your own case is different, because at this time, God is rearranging your life. I know about you. And when he does put your life together, then you'll know what to do. But I also want to share this with some of you. When many of you are desperate, you always find money somehow, somewhere, to do something. Is there somebody that can help us mute their phone, please? Is there somebody who you have your kids, or you're working in an office or something? Can you mute your phone? Okay.
Hello?
Yes.
Hi, my name is Paul, and I got in earlier because somebody called me earlier to tell me that you need to come to this service and you need to listen to it. And I believe that I talked to you personally, I mean, on the phone last time, Pastor.
Are you calling from Alaska?
No, I'm calling from Marshalltown, Iowa, but right now I'm in Denison, Iowa.
Okay.
I talked to you.
Yes, I remember you. I remember you.
Yes. So I just try to come in and listen to your service, and I like it. I like the way you guys were talking. You guys really have a chance to say what
to
say and everything. I like it. It's really good.
Okay.
But when I tell you that, I didn't tell you that, because I don't know what to do, so I was just listening. So.
Okay. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Is there somebody else who has ever visited a witch and all these kind of people?
Can I say
yeah. Hello? Yeah, this guy is still speaking. Let him finish.
Hello?
Yeah, let the guy who just spoke, let him finish speaking. Then the other two can speak. Please continue. The one from Iowa.
Okay. Well, what I'm saying is that I was baptized when I was a little kid. But it comes to me that I believe that it's a God. I know that. I understand that. You know, Son of God, I understand all that, but in my heart, I didn't feel it like it worked on me, the God worked on me, you know, like, I feel like everything that I do, I always, you know, ask that why God always let me do, because in my life, I've been, like, in a rough time, you know, from my young child until right now, so my life is really very miserable and everything, but I always felt that, what's wrong? Are you really dead? Are you watching me what I'm doing? Oh, why don't you, you know, help me with all this terrible time and everything? So I believe that it's God, but I don't feel it in my heart. God don't come to my heart that made me believe in it.
And that is the reason why I'm going to prove to you that God exists. Because you will experience things that are beyond you when I begin to minister to you. So let's keep in contact and you will see what will happen to you. And when they begin to happen, you better be prepared. Because if you argue too much and you don't feel it, I'll tell him to come and visit you and you better be prepared to see him. I will begin by telling him to send you a little angel to come and visit you. So you better be prepared. And in fact, there are some who doubt God so bad that I actually asked Jesus to come and visit. And I hope you'll be prepared for it. You see, there are things that are going to happen in your life, like miracles, like healings, like supernatural direction, like an open door from financial supply, opportunities for a job that will make you know that God is there. I mean, people have tried to do that for you, never work. But when I start, it will work for you. Okay?
Hello. Okay.
Okay, that's how it's going to be. There is a lady that wanted to speak right now. After that, Albert, you can speak. Which lady wanted to speak right now? Please go on. Emiliana?
Yes.
Okay, I see. Continue.
I was taken. I did not go willing. You know, I was taken to her.
Okay. I see. And that also means that from that day you were taken to her, as young as you were, a demon was sent to be your slave or to be your leader. I'll deal with that. Thanks for letting me know, okay?
Sometimes they've gotten mad at me because I won't pay the service that my mom has required, and then they want to fight me.
It was one lady from Salvador, and I said, no, if my mom and my sister require your service, this is 2005, why are you calling me? I said, you're a witch. You ought to know that I'm homeless, and I have no money. You do know that, don't you? She says, yeah, so where do you want me to pull it out of my butthole? I mean, I had to get like that with this woman because she was being very aggressive, so she said she was going to send me a bracelet, red and black. And I had met Cecilia Carey from Nigeria, Africa. She was a nun, and I told her what had happened. Well, you did what you did, like, that's not good. And I said, well, what do I do? Is she going to give it to your mom, or is she going to mail it to you? She's going to give it to my mom. And so you tell your mom not to send it to you. So I prayed to my mom that if it was something bad, that it wasn't going to come to my hands, because the seer carrier was from Africa. And if it didn't come to me, it was because it had something occurred or something really bad. My mother never had money to send it. So my mom got into a fight with the lady and told her. Ironically, when I went a couple of years back, the same lady that tried to hurt me was the same as they tried to commit suicide. And I had to minister to her as far as telling her about God and how could she be going to church and doing all these things that she could be doing.
Yep.
Before that, when my mom had been going to...
Do you know...
And I've been with her through all of them.
Let me share this with you. Many a time, those people who practice those things, look at how they die. Maybe that should scare many of you enough to know that you do not need to be there. Maria, thank you very much. Next.
Hi, it's Neva. So, basically, when I was younger, I went to a chariot reader, and I wanted to know about money, and I wanted to know if my current boyfriend, who was actually a missionary, and I was in California at the time, I wanted to know if he was going to be my husband. So, I don't know what she said, but there was only, like, two things that were semi-right, and everything else that she said was wrong. So, I left out of there, and I wasn't happy, but I was like, let me just go back. So I was like, she was semi-right, well, maybe she's going to be on the right track. So I went back, and I wanted to turn about the money anymore, so I wasn't, giving a simple answer. I said, well, what about the man? And my boyfriend is going to be my husband. And she wasn't, it was like, guilty if she wasn't sure of herself, so I left out of there. And
wow. Albert, what did you want to tell us? Thank you. Thank you, Geneva. Albert, what did you want to say? It seems he's off the line. Okay. I want you, wherever you are, to know something and to know this very carefully. Everything has a price. When you go to consult these things, there is a price with those things. Big, big price for any of these things. Don't think that these things, because it's cheap, they tell you to pay $10, $20, $100, or $1,000, that is that cheap. What you will pay is more than that money, and I hope you better be prepared for it. You better be prepared for it. Psychics are able to tell you deep things about you. The only thing they are not able to do, listen carefully. Please, I think, Maria, mute your phone. Maria, press mute. Both of you will still be hearing me. Press mute. Janet, are you on the line tonight?
I'm on the line.
Is there anyone who is moving around or who lives near? I don't know. You know who is that? Can you just press mute so that we can communicate? I do not want to mute people because this is a conversation kind of thing tonight. Everything you want to do with these people, with psychics, you're going to pay a price for it. And let me share this with you. Psychics are able to tell you things about you that are true, but they are not able to offer solutions. They are not able. I'm simply telling you the way it is. They cannot offer you solution. They can tell you how, why, but they cannot offer you any solution. The reason is because they are not connected with the solution. It is only someone like me and the rest of us in the camp of the living Jesus, in the camp of the Holy Ghost, in the camp of the Father, who are connected with solution. So get it now. You are only able to be free from all the pain and heartache and all the aches that comes with the other side if you turn to Christ himself. So Christ will not just reveal, but he will also solve. The other side can reveal, but they cannot solve. Psychic ability is what a lot of pastors are using. Psychic ability is what a lot of pastors are using. A lot of prophets, a lot of bishops, a lot of teachers, a lot of apostles. That is why the Bible tells us if there is any gift that you have to ask God to give to you, it is what we called the gift of the discernment of spirits. That is the most important gift in the world. Of all the gift of the Holy Ghost, cry and ask for that gift. Because if you have it, then you have everything. Because that is the only gift that will keep you from being fooled, from being manipulated, from being used, from being discarded, from being destroyed, from being stolen from. That is the most important gift of all gift. It is the only gift that can protect, promote, give you everything. It is the gift of the discernment of spirit. That is the gift that will help you to know who a person is. In a split second, you will know who somebody is. Just by talking to them, just by seeing their face, just by hearing their name, you will know immediately who they are. It's immediate. You don't go to school to learn it because the Holy Ghost in you will just tell you. There will be time that I will start teaching on spiritual gift. If I start teaching on spiritual gift from January, by the time we finish, it will be next January again. It will take me a whole year to teach. Too much a day. Too much thing. I need really to concentrate to do those kind of work and to write about them. And they are not things that I do just so easily. I'm telling you. Because without the discernment of spirit, you're doomed. Because there are people who are willing to be deceived. And don't be that person because they are desperate. Don't let desperation and problems lead you to bigger problems. And when you have problems, that is the time people are going to dupe you. That's the time people are going to deceive you. When they sense that you have problem and they can sense it very easily. Psychics have the ability of both fallen stars and demons to know exactly who you are and what you're going through in the soul realm and sometimes in the spirit realm. They can open your spirit up. They can open your soul up and be able to extract information about you and about your DNA. What has been going on in your life for many generations, they can do it. The only problem is that they do not have any solution. The same thing with pastors who can see. There are pastors who have psychic ability to heal. The only problem is that those healings do not last. They can finish healing you, and it doesn't take long, you die. You become crippled. They can cure you of cancer, and tomorrow the cancer is gone, but the next thing you become lame or paralyzed or deaf or dumb or something. They always replace something with something. Just hold it, hold it, hold it. There's something going on here. So I want you to be very careful about this. Many, many churches, many pastors use psychic ability. That's what they use. Okay, Kishan, what did you want to say?
That guy that I went to go see, well, when me and Amanda decided to leave home, we said we wasn't going to do it anymore. I don't know if it's a demon or a fallen angel, but it's definitely a demon that opened and closed doors, so they say. And he said, if I mess up with that demon, he will make my life a living hell. And me and Amanda wrapped the idol up, and we threw it in the woods. And I remember that's when we met you. We passed him one day in a parking lot, and me and Amanda both stopped, and like something weird happened. Like he looked at us and like shook his head, and like we were just puzzled, but we know something weird happened, and that came to my mind. And I forgot to tell you that. He said, if I ever mess up with that, I don't know if it's a demon or a fallen angel, but if I ever mess up with it, it'll make my life a living hell. So is there any truth to that? Is that a curse?
I don't know. I'm not going into that. I think we've exhausted what we wanted. What we wanted to do tonight. I want you, wherever you are, to begin to pray. It is you that is going to break whatever you went and bought. It is you that is going to break whatever your parent went and bought for you. Begin to break them right now. Begin to break them. Go on, break them. Use your mouth. Don't look for me to break them. Send those things back. Tell those demons that you let them go tonight. Tell all the demons you acquired, your parents acquired for you and for the family. Tell them that you dismiss them, that you do not want their services anymore, that you are willing to let them go now. Tell them you are willing to let them go. Tell them that their service is over. You do not need their services anymore. Okay. that you are no longer their master, you are no longer their mistress. You are no longer their wife, they are no longer your wife, you are no longer their husband, they are no longer your husband. Tell them that they are dismissed, their job is over, let them go. Every curse that any psychic has put on your family or on you, dismiss, destroy it now. Destroy it now. Destroy those curses now. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, wherever you are in the world, touch my hands because I begin to release the force of the living God into your life and activities. So listen carefully, all of you. I'm now ministering. I dismiss the services of every ruling demons and fallen stars in your bloodline and in your life and in everything that you've been doing. Please hold it, hold it. I'm ministering now. I'm ministering now. Let there be lights that exposes all darkness. Let the power of God move very strongly all over your life and activities. Let there be, let the anointing break every yoke now. Every doors that were opened for the world. I'm not satisfied with what we've been saying. So listen carefully to what I'm going to tell you. Please, please, please don't pray anymore. Please, nobody should make any move right now. If you are in the office, if you are at home and you are moving about, you are doing something, mute your phone, because what I'm going to say now is very important. You do not need to say anything. Please listen very carefully.
callers are muted and they can unmute themselves.
A psychic can influence you from very far away. A psychic, whether it's a witch, whether it's a warlock, a wizard, whether it's an astrologer, a fortune teller, a diviner, a shaman, a medicine man, a herbalist, a witch doctor, can control your mind, your will, your intelligence, your money, your marriage, your children, through the forces of wickedness from far away or from near. There is what we call psychic manipulation. And anyone who practices the dark art and who belongs to the dark forces can manipulate your intelligence. Your dreams can be manipulated. They can manipulate your brain, your physical existence in this world could be manipulated through psychic projections, psychic movements. The psychic can powerfully manipulate you so as to bring you to that place where you become useless the rest of your life. You see, the world is divided between those who know and those who are ignorant. And those who practice the dark art call themselves the enlightened one, the light bearers. Whereas in reality, we, the Christians, are actually the light bearers of God. We are actually the enlightened ones. They call themselves those who have knowledge, but we are actually the ones who do. They can project thoughts. In fact, let me tell you something. Psychics practices astrological things also. There are people who are just psychics, but there are also people who are both astrologers, fortune tellers, witches, all kind of stuff, all in one person. And when they combine this with psychic art, they are able to demonstrate powerfully how if you're weak and afraid, and you don't even know you're right in Christ, you cannot stand your ground, you are not bold, you'll become a pawn. They can manipulate you for their own personal gain and for your own personal destruction. Psychics who are also astrologers will involve themselves in astral attack and psychic attack. Your soul will be attacked. Your memory will be attacked. The machine of psychic attack is very strong. They will attack your emotion. And that's why some of you in the morning you are happy, in the night you are miserable. And you don't know why. Or in the night you are happy, you drank some beer, ate some good food, wake up in the morning for no reason. You don't feel happy and you don't know why. It's crazy. Psychic attack are real. They can attack your job. So that you don't really like your job, you start complaining and whining and problems. They can attack. You used to be very good at what you do. Suddenly, you don't feel like doing it again. someone somewhere is sending out some hexes against you. This thing comes by various names, but it's the same thing. Psychic attack, area. They will attack you when you sleep. They will attack you when you are awake. They will attack anything you try to do. Especially if they've targeted you as an enemy. That's why you need to be closer to God, so that you are not subject to psychic and astral attack and manipulation. They can manipulate your emotion and you never feel good or healthy, so that you come to them. If you cannot go to them to seek for help, they will make you go there, so that they will be in charge of you. Psychic attack are true. Watch your dreams, you will know whether you are being psychically attacked. You and somebody got into an argument in your office, and in the night you're having a nightmare. You think they are not connected, they are. Somebody has not forgiven you in the past, still trying to haunt you, is wishing you dead. Do something about it. Put an end to it. Just say, in the name of Jesus, I put a stop to every psychic attack, every psychic manipulation, every astral travels to manipulate, to destroy. Let me continue to pray for you.
All callers are muted. All callers are unmuted.
Tonight, as you go to your bed to sleep, or if you are just waking up to this video, take this very serious. I want you to begin to take Jesus very serious and the Bible, and believe what he says, because those people, they believe what their own book says about them. Do you believe what the Bible says about you? You're still arguing over what Jesus says. Those people have no time to argue over anything. They believe it just as it is, and it works for them just as it is. As you go home tonight, I want you to know that you've been delivered. The blood of the Son of God has delivered you and set you free. You are free forever. If you like, go on doubting. Go on being weak. Instead of you doing everything to stand strong in Christ. Those people believe whatever their book says. They don't doubt it. They don't even doubt it one day. And you, Christ will tell you, do this. You doubt forever. You argue forever. Those guys have no time to argue. Because in their own organization, there is no argument. You better believe it or you get out. You don't want to believe it. They ask you, okay, stand there. Somebody brings a knife or a scissor or a razor blade and cut your flesh and put the blood in a plate. And that person cut him or herself and put his or her blood and mix with yours. Everyone will cut themselves and they mix all their blood together. And everybody will have a share of each other's blood. Now tell me, and do you know what power has been released when they do that? Especially when they call a demon to be a witness to the force of the covenant of the blood. You think these are jokes? That's why sometimes you're praying and the demon tell you they have little right. He said there is a blood covenant here. And if you've ever had a blood covenant with somebody, you better call me fast. You better. Because I have to replace that with the blood of Christ. And here you are told to believe in Jesus and in his blood. You are arguing, is this real? Is that real? But go to those places. They will ask you to bring a goat or a cat or a dog or an animal. one form of animal or the other, or a cow, and they will kill it, and they will take the blood. You watch and see what they do with the blood. Sometimes they bathe you, they give you a bath with the blood. You think those things are a joke? You think it's a joke? Are you serious? These are not a joke. These are serious stuff. And the day they bathe you with the blood of an animal, you start to see demon face to face. You start to see somebody come to your house to visit you. You start to see shadowy things in your home. The day they put a ring on your finger, you start to see somebody following you for no reason. You think those things are jokes? Psychic powers are real. I send you home tonight to know that the Son of God has set every one of you free who is on the line tonight. And those of you who are watching me, you are free. And if you need further help, call me next week. I have done too much this week. I need to rest tomorrow and Sunday. Please join me tomorrow morning for prayer, 8 o'clock Central Time, 8 in the morning. Find out what 8 in the morning means in your local time. I have sent each of you an email. Please read my email. Read it carefully. Don't be in a haste so that you know what programs I'm doing daily. Tomorrow, Saturday, I am only having one program, the morning program by 8 o'clock, the morning prayer. Sunday, I have the morning prayer by 8 o'clock. But I will also have Sunday service for those of you who do not have a church home. While you wait for me to come to your city and start a church, please join me by 10 o'clock Central Time on Sunday morning for Sunday service. This is every Sunday. And all my programs, you can also watch them on Justin TV. And you can call in on the prayer line number 424-203-8400. And the code is 955-967 and the pound sign. Please join me. And also, I call on you to support what I'm doing. I spent a lot of money to make these things happen and also to support pastors out there who I am also training. As I'm talking to you today, there are 3 or 4 more pastors that have called in that have just sent me their requests for them to be trained to become pastors. Takes a lot to do some of these things. I ask God to bless you. And now let me pray. Let everything that has been against you break down. Every door that will open against you, close. Every door that will close against you, open. Every demon that has been working for you and your family, dismissed from duty. From tonight, every psychic and astral attack, I command them to be destroyed. Be destroyed in Jesus' name. You are free to go home and begin to enjoy life. God bless you. This is Idika Imeri saying to you, good night. And if you still want to pray, let me say something to you. Please, please, please. I don't want you to discuss. If you still want to stay on the prayer line and pray, please, I want you to begin to pray until when you are satisfied, then you leave the prayer line. Please just pray. Spend this time. Let this be a time that you want to pray. If you want to keep praying, just pray for the next 10, 20, 15 minutes. You can just stay on the prayer line and just pray. Because the power of God is very, very heavy right on the prayer line tonight. If you want to just stay and pray or just stay there and just talk to God for a while, then you can now go home and start your weekend. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.
Devon, Devon.
Yeah, yeah.
How are you, my man?
Hello. I'm good. I'm good. How are you?
I'm here. Yeah. Just where you left me, that's where I am.
Yeah.
Are the family still out there at the P place?
No, the back room, no.
Oh, they are back? Okay. Were they able to get their package or something?
Yes, they did.
What did she say when she opened it?
Bishop.
Yes?
Are you still playing on Justin TV?
Yes.
Oh, okay. I didn't think you wanted to be on there.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to turn it off now.
Okay. Bye.
Make sure you call me, please, Mama.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, Justin TV is off now. So.
To stop conference recording, press 1. Your conference recording has stopped.
Okay. Let me stop recording on.